Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at using the Edit Motion Layer tool to animate your characters. This flexible tool can be used for everything from creating poses to adding adjustments to existing motions and creating your own custom keyframe animations. The first thing to keep in mind is that your character must be a CC avatar or humanoid type to utilize this tool. You can access the Edit Motion Layer tool from the Animation tab of the Modify panel and also directly from the Animation menu at the top. For hotkeys, you can use 3 or N to bring it up. The first thing you'll see in the Edit Motion Layer panel is the dummy with a bunch of control points. You can click on either the control points of the dummy or the actual bone joints on the character to adjust them. You can also use the up and down hotkeys to go up or down the bone hierarchy as well. Once a bone is selected, you can use the Home hotkey to zoom in on it for more detailed editing. In terms of visualization, you can adjust the appearance and opacity of both your character's IK control points and bones by using the respective setting buttons at the top right of your control panel. In this case, I'm simply going to disable the bone display and only show the rig control points to make things a bit cleaner for this demo. Once you have a control point, you can use the W hotkey to toggle the Move Tool gizmo. Please note that there is a World and Local mode for the Move Tool. World corresponds to the alignment of your entire scene, while Local corresponds to the local position of the particular control point you've selected. You can use the W hotkey to toggle between the two. You also have the option to rotate bones and control points as well. The hotkey for toggling rotation type is E. You can see the rotation gizmo change as E is pressed from local to world values. One thing to notice is that there are little cubes on the character's hand. These are end effectors for the character, which are used for tweaking a character's pose in more detail using inverse kinematics or IK for both the hands and feet. You can see that the feet also have end effectors, and the rotation of your foot will vary based on which end effector you have selected. If you right-click on one of your end effectors, you have the option to edit the effector pivot. This allows you to refine the position and rotation of your end effector point to suit whichever scenario you encounter. Okay, let's take a look at the two main modes in the Edit Motion Layer tool, Forward Kinematics, or FK, and Inverse Kinematics, or IK. Let's look at FK first. If we go into the FK mode section, you'll see a list of the character's bone hierarchy appear. You can select individual bones and adjust them directly. FK mode is fairly simple. If you select a parent bone and rotate it, then all of the child bone positions will also be affected. So basically, it's just going forward down the bone hierarchy list. This mode is important because it also allows you to adjust the used or extend bones, which often correspond to things like tails or ears. These extend bones aren't utilized in conventional CC avatar or humanoid characters, and therefore can't utilize IK mode properly. Speaking of IK mode, let's explore that by going into the IK mode section. In IK mode, you can still adjust the parent bones and influence the position and rotation of the child bones, but now you also have the option to move the child bones and have them naturally affect the position of the parent bones. You can see the normal behavior, just like FK mode when I adjust the position of the parent bones on the arms. However, if I adjust the position of the hand bone in IK mode, you'll see that it will also influence the entire parent bone hierarchy. If I select the hip control point and move it, the feet will remain planted, because they are utilizing IK effectors, which means they'll stay in contact with the ground. We'll look at this in more detail in future tutorials. Okay, let's take a look at creating a simple pose now using IK mode. I can use the Reset Pose button at the top left to reset my character to the default standing pose, and then continue on to select various child bones to get my character into sort of a forward punch pose. I can utilize the IK effectors on the feet in combination with the IK control points to have the rear foot on its toes. It will not poke through the ground mesh as long as you have those IK effectors enabled. It's also super easy to bring all of your fingers into a fist for custom hand gesture by using the palm control points in the dummy area as well. Using all of these features, it's super easy to put together a cool-looking pose in minutes. Let's look at how we can utilize the pin feature to keep our character's hands in place as the rest of the body moves in a natural way. Notice that at present, if I rotate this character's hips, that it will influence everything, disconnecting her hands from the box, and her feet will float as well. If I press the little lock button beside her left hand, you'll see a T and an R appear at that control point. T stands for transform or move, and R stands for rotate. That means both the position and rotation of that hand will now be locked. There are some lock presets at the bottom. I'll select no pin here, which will reset and disable all of the pins. Then I can use the pin both hands preset to lock both of them in position. You'll see the predictable result if I rotate the hips now. Next, let's try pin limbs. Once we do, you'll see the T and R appear on both hands and ankle control points. Now when I rotate the hips, you'll see the inverse kinematics at play as the torso moves naturally despite the hands and feet pinned into place. You can combine fun variations on this with other tools as well. In this case, I have my character's hands pinned while the feet are free. I'm going to open up the Direct Puppet tool, which allows me to puppet the position of the control points in real time using various techniques. The Direct Puppet tool has the same pin presets, so I'll use the hand preset for now. If I select the hip and preview with a move gizmo, I can preview and let my mouse movements drive the hip position in real time. Okay, finally, let's take a look at how we can use the Edit Motion Layer tool to customize existing motions, which is probably its most common usage. Here I have a simple animation of a dude walking along, and you can see the motion clip in the timeline. First, I'll ensure I'm at the first frame of that clip, then I can use the Edit Motion Layer tool to rotate the shoulders upwards. If I play back, you'll see the edit I made will last for the duration of the clip. If I want to add additional edits onto that base motion clip, then I can enter into the Animation Layer tool and create a new layer. I'll name that layer Torso and do a slight rotation edit to my character's torso at various intervals along the timeline. I can copy and paste the main keyframes from each edit down the timeline to make it faster. You can enable or disable each layer on the Animation Layer tool for various results. Using this together with the Edit Motion Layer tool gives you complete freedom and customization over your animations. That's it for this video, guys. Be sure to check out our other motion tool tutorials in our Learning Center, and I'll see you in the next video.